Thank you, God. Let us pray. Father God, I just thank you this morning, God, for what you're getting ready to do, Lord God. Father, I decrease that you may increase in me, Lord God. Father, your word and your sayings, Lord God. Father, I pray that you use me in a glorious manner today, that you may be glorified, God. Father, right now, move all hindrance out the way, Lord God. Take away every stronghold, God. Father, I hide behind the cross, Lord God, that you may be revealed, Lord God. Father, I am but a vessel that you pour your spirit through, Lord God. Father, right now, feed your sheep, Lord God. We need to hear a word from you today, God. Father, we pray right now, Lord, you use me for your service, God. Father, make me a flame of fire, Lord God, for your service to your people, God. Let every word be effective that proceeds out of my mouth, God. Father, you said that your word will not return void. So, Father, we pray now that the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart will be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And in Acts chapter 12, starting at the first verse, it reads, "And about that time, Herod the king stretched forth his hands to get certain of the church, and he killed James, the brother of John, with the sword. And because he saw it pleased the Jews, he proceeded further to take Peter also. And then were the days of unleavened bread. And when he had approached him, he put him in prison and delivered him to four coordinations of soldiers and kept him, intending after Easter to bring him forth to the people. And Peter therefore was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church of God for him. And when Herod would have brought him forth the same night, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with two chains. And the keepers before the door kept the prison. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and a light shined in the prison. And he spoke Peter and said, Rise him up, saying, Arise up quickly. And his chains fell off from him, from his hands. And the angel said unto him, Gird thyself and bind thy sandals. And so he did. And he saith unto him, Cast thy garments about thee and follow me. And he went out and followed him, and wist not that it was true which was done by the angel, but though he saw a vision. And when he were past the first and the second ward, they came unto an iron gate that leadeth unto the city, which opened to them of his own accord. And they went out and passed on through the streets. And forward the angel departed from him. And when Peter was come to him, he said, Now I know of surely that the Lord has sent his angel and has delivered me out of the hands of Herod and from all the expectations of the people of the Jews. Amen. Thus I've read Acts 12, 1 through 11. Amen.
Amen.
And if I was going to take for a topic today, my topic would be, hold on, help is on the way. Amen.
Amen.
Come on and give God some praise in here. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, hold on, help is on the way. Amen. Now, when we look at this verse of chapter, we see that in the beginning, we see that Peter is one that was one of the disciples of God. Amen. We know that he was one that walked upright before God. We know that Peter was not a coward. Peter was always one that was willing to fight. Amen. How many of you know that sometimes we got to be willing to fight, especially in today's times? Now, when we begin to read this verse of script right here, we see that not only was Herod the king doing things that pleased the people, he began to see because what he was doing to a certain sect, and that sect being the people of God, it pleased them. How many of you know that people will do things to you because it pleases somebody else?
Amen.
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 They'll come against you. They'll take their sides. They'll make a mockery feels good. Amen. But I believe that as long as we stand firm, fixed, and set in the things of God, help is always going to be on the way.
Amen.
I believe I read in the Bible that God said, as long as I am for you, I'm more than the entire world against you. Now, the one thing that we got to see that at this time, it was nothing to kill a Christian. You know, it's just like that today. When we look back and we see what just happened in South Carolina, they walk up in there, sat among them, and then begin to attack. How many of you know that the devil is poised, waiting to strike? Amen. But we as the people of God, we got to realize that we cannot give up on the very fixation that God will help us. Amen. Oh, come on, y'all with me today. See, I need y'all to know that we are not in this thing for no reason at all, but we are in it because God said we shall have the victory. Now, when I begin to read this a little more, I see that not only were they going to make it difficult for him, how many of you know sometimes they'll put you away and hold you back so they can laugh at you later?
Right.
Come on now.
Yeah.
You know them times when you know your zipper was down and everybody knew it but you. Nobody wanted to say nothing to you because it was all right as long as you was the fool. Oh, come on now. You walked around with that book in your eye and your best friend didn't tell you. But they called themselves your friends. Oh my God. Now we begin to see that Peter, knowing they knew Peter was one that walked with Christ. They knew he was one that sat at his feet and he learned. They knew that Peter believed Christ. How many of you know that the world knows that you believe? Amen. But how many of you know it's more than what you believe? You got to go past what you believe and you got to begin to know. If you know that God is real, come on and give him some praise in here. Yeah. See, it was okay for me to just believe in him, thinking that was just enough. But I got to know above everything else that no matter how the devil comes against me, no matter how he's trying to tear my house down, no matter how he's pulled things away from me, I know that God will help. Help is on the way. Now, when we see Peter being thrown into the furthermost prisons, see, they didn't just want to do him any kind of way. They took him to the deepest, the darkest part of the prison, locking him away from everybody. In other words, if you get past this point, you still got to get past this point. Come on, how many of you been at that point in your life?
Amen.
Well, soon as you get over one thing, here comes something else that I got to get over. Soon as I get past this, I got to get past that. And you will leave it in your mind, ask yourself, Lord, where are you now? Where are you going through all of your trials? But I want you to know, child of God, God is not strong. I mean, he's not disapproving of what you're going through. He knows where you are. Now, when we go through these things, the devil wants us to believe that God is not going to come to my rescue. But I know that in the midst of everything that I go through, God is already there. Now, how many of you know that when we begin to pray, we're not just praying for right now, but I got to pray for things further on down the road. See, the devil just don't want to destroy you right now. He wants to take away your whole lineage. He don't want your children to be saved. Children to be saved. So guess what? If I stop you from knowing now, everything else will fail afterwards. See, sometimes we don't realize the onset of lives that we have in the lives of other Christians. Amen. When we can tell them, we can even encourage them, or we can discourage them. Amen. How many of you were discouraged before you came to Christ?
Amen.
So why would I want to be discouraged in Christ? I need to be encouraged.
Amen.
I was discouraged before I got here.
Amen.
Now, when it comes to Peter, we know that Peter was a fighter. Mm-hmm. Peter believed that no matter what was going on, somehow or another, I'm going to make my way out of this.
Amen.
Now, as he sat there and he began to pray himself, here comes the angel of the Lord showing up.
Yes.
Sometimes we don't even see the angel of the Lord in our stead because we get so caught up in the situation. Amen. We take our eye off of what God is getting ready to do. We front of us instead of knowing where God is going to take me to.
Amen.
Now I believe when the word said that we are to walk by faith and not by sight, it was because God needed us to go where he wants us to be.
Amen.
Not stay where we're seeing right now.
Yes.
Now I can imagine that if Peter was in the deepest dark parts of this prison, he couldn't see nothing at all. But when he began to know that prayer was went up for me.
Yes.
Prayer was made for me.
Yes.
And because this prayer was made for me, something has to begin to shake loose.
Oh, yeah.
If it doesn't shake loose now, it's surely going to shake loose later. Because in the mind of his heart, he had to know that Herod wants to kill me.
Yes.
How many of you know the devil wants to kill you right now?
Yes,
he don't want you to see the salvation of the Lord revealed in your heart.
Yes.
He doesn't want you to see the hope of glory that's going to be revealed to you. He don't want you to see the prayers of the righteous answered in your life.
Yes.
He wants you to believe that this is the worst that it's going to get.
Amen.
He wants you to throw up your hands and surrender and say, I'm tired of fighting. Mm-hmm. Well, how many of you know sometimes you got to fight when you're tired?
Yes.
You got to fight when you're on your back.
Yes.
You got to fight when you're up against the wall.
Yes.
You got to fight when you're up. You got to fight when you're down. And you got to do it all in the name of Jesus. Now, I can imagine that the people of God, as they knew Peter because he was a leader, was locked up in prison, and they seen their Messiah hung upon the cross, and then they seen the next in command locked in prison, knowing that they're killing him.
Yeah.
So what does that mean for me?
Jesus.
How many of you know that you can't see what's going on around you?
That's right.
You got to look past all of that and know that God has a much greater privilege for you. God didn't give us certain promises in our lives not to have them fulfilled. But see, this is the thing that I realize as children of God, we stop at the very persistence of pressure. When things are in our face, we don't like it. But we expect God to bless us. But we don't want to be persevering in the things of God.
Amen.
Come on, how do I know? Because some of us don't want to love right. Some of us don't want to walk in obedience. Some of us don't want to let go of the old things that keep us bound up.
Amen.
To draw closer to God.
Amen.
But how about nowadays, the devil don't care nothing about what you do.
That's right.
Come on now, we just saw how he walked up in the house of God.
Yes.
And began to slay the people of God.
Yes.
But we don't want to get it right. You know, it would be a sad thing if somebody in that church wasn't really saved.
Yes.
Serving God as in a form of godliness.
Yes.
How many of you know God is not pleased with just a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof?
Amen.
God wants us to have the full power of God. Amen.
Amen.
That means that no matter if I'm in this situation right now, God, I know you're going to make a way. I'm not going to stop trusting you because I didn't get the job.
Yeah.
I'm not going to stop trusting you because my lights got cut off. I'm not going to stop trusting you because now all of a sudden I'm bankrupt and they repossess my car. But I'm going to believe you in spite of my situations. I'm going to believe you because in the process of my believing, I know that you hung, you bled, you died for me. And I know that that precious blood is still covering me even today.
Yes, yes, yes.
See, we don't realize what the power of the blood really represents.
Yes.
We don't understand that it is the very purpose of his death that brought us into the newness of life. Amen.
Amen.
Now, why do we think that if we died with Christ and that we're in the newness of life risen, that the devil was just going to let us walk free?
Amen.
Amen. See, we don't realize that in the process of being saved, there was a price that had to be paid.
Yeah.
There is a price that's still being paid.
Yeah.
And we got to hold the battle line.
Yes.
We can't let the wall fall down.
All right.
We got to stand and know that, yes, for God I'm going to live.
Amen.
And for God I shall die.
Amen.
How many of you are ready to really die in Christ today? Amen.
Amen.
If you took your last breath today, you know that everything would be all right. I ain't got to think on it. I ain't got to worry about it. I ain't got to plead for my life
Jesus.
Oh, come on.
All right,
but see, when I know that my Redeemer lives, when I know that he hung, he bled, he died to save me, when I know that I'm changed simply because of what he did in my life, that I don't have to be the same anymore. When we step out of our way, God can step in the way.
Amen.
John, 1 John 4:4 says, you are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because he who is in you is greater than he that is in the world.
Amen.
Now, knowing that, yes, the devil is he's the prince of the air. Don't you know the reason why you come up with the attack is because he doesn't want you to have what God says you have dominion over.
Amen.
He wants to bring you doubt before you get your true blessing. How many of you have been at the gate of your blessing and then all of a sudden it changed?
Amen.
But see, how many of you know that sometimes that change was the change you needed to get you to your real blessing?
Amen.
God wanted something greater than you ever. Because I believe the word says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what God has prepared for man.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
So then we can't even fathom what God is already doing in our lives.
Amen.
I believe the word says that he'll do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can even say or even think.
Yes. That's right.
So I said one thing, but God says, I got something so much greater for you. Yes, you thought your life was falling apart, but I needed it to fall apart so I could put it back together again. Yes, you thought that the family was destroyed, but I needed it to be burnt so I could rise it up from the ashes. See, a lot of people will look at your life and they won't see the beauty because of the ashes. But God says, I'll give you beauty for your ashes. Yes, he will. He'll burn up something so he can make something greater. Amen. Now, I can imagine that when Paul walked up out of this prison, his faith was a little stronger now. Amen. How many of you know that without a test, you can't have a testimony?
All right.
Amen.
All right.
Some of us just want to walk into the blessing. Amen. Don't want to go through nothing. All we can say is, God blessed me. But it's good to be able to say, well, before God blessed me, I had to lay flat on my face. I had to fast 40 days and 40 nights. And it wasn't because I had to fast or because I needed to fast. It was because there wasn't no food in the house.
All right.
Oh, come on now.
All right.
But then I began to fast and I began to believe God. And God began to deliver.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
How you going to know how to fight if you ain't never been in a fight? How you going to know? How you going to know that you need to be delivered if you don't know what you're being delivered from?
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
We'll sit still and think that God is just going to do what he needs to do, but he's going to do it without taking me through nothing.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to go through something to get to something. Amen.
Amen.
All right. You got to fight for what you want.
Amen.
Come on now. You remember that in times past, if we wanted to do something, it was always you had to try. You had to try all.
Amen.
God wants us to know that I'm here for you.
Yes, he is.
I need you to be here for me.
Amen.
I need you to know that, yes, I'll deliver you, but I got to know that you want to be delivered.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes,
how many of us change our minds in the process? Come on now. I got saved, but wait a minute. I remember that party that I went to the other night. They had an anomaly. I just might go on a team.
Yeah.
No. God wants to know that our minds is made up on
That's
him.
Right.
That our hearts is set on him.
Right.
That we are at a point where, listen, I'm tired of being halted between the two opinions. I'm going to be in and not out.
Amen.
I'm going to be above and not beneath. I'll be the head and not the tail.
Amen.
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 So I can imagine that when Peter was even knocking at the door of the saints that had been praying for him, right at his deliverance. Other people on the other side of the door hear the knock.
Mm-hmm.
And he's calling, it's me, it's Peter. But how many of you know some people won't believe that you've just been delivered? Standing at the front door of your deliverance, knocking. And they're saying, you ain't here. You're not what you say you are. You're not delivered. You still right in that prison cell. And I'm right here. How many of you know that sometimes prayers have gone up and then when the prayers are answered, you sitting back wondering, did he just do that? Yeah. Did he just answer my prayer?
Yeah.
That's because you didn't know. It takes more than just believing. You got to know.
Amen.
When you begin to know, God will begin to manifest. Amen.
Amen.
And when God begins to manifest, we begin to walk in his perfect will. Amen.
Amen.
One thing that I know above everything else, that living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, risen he justified and freed me forever, and someday he's coming back.
Oh yes, he is.
What a glorious day. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, let's give God some praise. Father God, we just thank you now for your word, Lord God. We bless you, God, with your strength, your power, and your might, Lord God. Father, give us the strength to stand fast, even in the times of adversity, Lord God. Father, give us the will to stand in the times of fright, Lord, and when the battle is raging, Lord God. Father, we know that you are our keeper, God. You are the one that will cause us to be steadfast and unmovable, God. Plant us deep in you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Come on and give God praise again.